So we now consider a situation where we have a lottery of lotteries. So again, we have n outcomes indexed 1 through n. Oops. Each lottery is a probability vector. Assigned to each outcome. But we have k lottery, so each lottery is indexed with a little k like this. And so what is a lottery of lotteries? Well, it's a vector, which is a vector of probabilities assigned to each lottery. So for a compound lottery, we have a vector, so for lottery 1 through k, we assign a vector of probability that each lottery happens, alpha 1 through k. Okay. So let's imagine that we do have a compound lottery. We have L1. L2 all the way to LK. We have K lotteries, and each lottery assigns a probability P1 to the first outcome, P2 to the second outcome, Pn to the nth outcome. So this is outcome 1 to N. Each lottery has a probability of occurrence, right? Alpha 1, alpha 2, and alpha k. And here we can put a subscript here. This is for the first lottery, k equal 1. This is for the second lottery. This is here is for the kth lottery. Now what we're looking to do here is we're looking to calculate a corresponding reduced lottery, which gives us a simple lottery that generates the same distribution over outcomes as this compound lottery here. So let's look at each outcome and try to figure out what is the probability for that outcome to occur. So if we look at the first outcome, n equal 1, so we're looking here at the sum of all of these probabilities multiplied by the probability that each lottery occur. So we're going to be doing a weighted sum of probabilities here. Alpha 1 times P11 plus alpha 2 times P12 all the way to K. So all we're doing is looking at the probability of the first outcome occurring, but in each lottery, and multiplied by the probability of each such lottery. Now, more generally, for the nth outcome, we can simply write, that the probability of that outcome occurring, Pn, is going to be equal to alpha 1 times the probability of outcome n in the first lottery plus alpha 2 times the probability of outcome n in the second lottery and all the way up to k. So for the kth lottery, alpha k times the probability of outcome n occurring in the kth lottery. So the reduced lottery is simply going to be a vector of probabilities for 1 through n. It's going to be a vector p1, p2, pn, all the way up to capital N. Sorry, this should be capital N here. And this vector here is the simple lottery representation of the compound lottery. Now, why do we care about this, by the way? The reason is that we can study any lottery of lotteries, any compound lottery, simply by looking at the reduced form. And that's going to make our life easier. Let me give you a quick example taken from the book. If I'm considering a situation with 3 outcomes and 3 lotteries, so the first lottery, L1, is the following probability vector. L2 is the following vector. And L3 and the compound lottery, the compound lottery is simply these 3 lotteries happening each with a probability of 1/3. Okay, so we're looking for the reduced lottery that gives us a simple lottery representation for this. How do we do this? We multiply each probability by the relevant alpha. So here we can multiply the first lottery by its probability of occurrence, which is 1/3. We can multiply the second lottery by its probability of occurrence. So it's going to be 1/12, 1/8, 1/8. And same thing here. Now, in order to generate the simple lottery, we have to sum these things up. So for the first outcome, we have to sum up 1/3 plus 1/12 plus 1/12. For the second outcome, 0 plus 1/8 plus 1/8, and same thing for the third outcome. So let's do this really quickly. So 1/3 plus 1/12 plus 1/12 is actually 1/3 plus 1/6. That's right, so that gives us actually 1/2. And then 0 plus 1/8 plus 1/8 is 1/4. 1/4. And this vector here, that is a vector of probabilities assigned to each outcome, and that is actually our simple form representation of the compound lottery here.